Okay, so again, good afternoon. So our topic for today is all about hypothesis testing. So before we will begin the lecture, okay, kindly prepare the following files. Okay, I already sent this in our GC and in our Moodle, no? Kindly look at sa LMS Moodle natin na upload na rin yun. So I'm talking about these following files, okay? Okay, the first file is the formula. Okay, ito yung formula. Maybe we'll just focus on the first two. Okay, kasi yung simple lang. At least you have the knowledge but regarding this hypothesis testing. No? Because the next topic will be analysis of variance, no? Or ANOVA. Okay, this file, then followed by the Z or T distribution tables. No? Okay, this file. Tagal mag-open, no? Ayan. No, not. Ito. Okay? Yung table na to. Okay. Close ko lang to. And we need also this file, no? So, yung lecture natin today. Okay. Now, last time, I asked the class regarding two terms, okay? The first term is all about descriptive statistics, okay? Somebody told us descriptive statistics just merely describing the data. So we're talking about the percentage, okay? We're talking about the average, the mode, the mean, the median, or descriptive statistics means also yung decile, percentile, quartile, okay? And ano pa ba? Standard deviation also. Actually, linear regression equations at correlations under descriptive statistics, no? So in short, again, okay, descriptive statistics, you're just merely describing the data. Okay? On the other hand, the second classification of statistics, the second term, is inferential statistics. Okay? When we're talking about inferential statistics, okay, from the word inference. Inference means conclusion. Okay? So, bakit siya conclusion, sir? Okay, later, you will know, no? The conclusion siya. Because from the population, you gather or you get a portion of that, which is called sample size. Okay, from that sample size, you get data, okay? From that data, you will conclude, ito ang, this is true also, okay? Doon sa population. It's more a conclusion, okay? So the first example of inferential statistics is testing hypothesis or hypothesis testing, okay? Now, at the end of this lecture, you are, the students should able to okay, enumerate all given in the problem. Okay, identify if t-test or z-test. Then identify the critical regions. Okay, compute for the t or z value. And you're asked to discuss step number 6. Okay. Now, example tayo kaagad, no? Now, example, a random sample of 100 cans okay, of beef mechado were collected by the quality control inspector from the last production. Batch production batch had an average net weight of 710.8 grams of beef meat chunks. Assuming a population standard deviation of 8.9 grams, does this seem to indicate that the mean net weight of beef chunks is greater than 700 grams used and you're asked to use a 0.05 level of significance? Okay, can we look at the problem? In reality, hindi lang 100 na cans ang ipuproduce ng kumpanya na yan. It could be thousands, right? Now, since before mo siya ibenta, dapat i-check mo ng quality niya, di ba? Kung tama bang nilagay mo dun sa label. It's not practical na i-open mo lahat yun. Wala ka nang ibebenta kung naka-open na. So, you find ways, okay, na para to get a portion of that to represent the total cans, no? Produced on that, let's say, batch, no? So, kumuha siya ng 100 using a certain formula. Okay? It depends on the company kung saan sila, kung saan talaga yung credible na formula gagamitin nila o nakasanayan nila based on historical data. In this case, kumuha sila ng 100. Random. Okay? So, inopen nila, gidrain nila yung liquid, in record nila yung 100 na yun, they came up with this data. Okay, ano bang sinabi dito? Okay. Okay, 100. Okay. 710. Okay, ito yun, no? Tama ba? Karugtong to ng sample sa ng random sample. So, ito yung data, 710.8, no? Then, given yung population standard deviation, okay, based on historical data, example, naggumawa sila ng, nagproduce sila ng dilata. Ano lang, maybe 500 pieces, no? Or na produce that in that specific time, no? Ibig sabihin, lahat na yun, okay? Historically, no? Lahat na yun na produce na 500. So, kinuha nila ng data, okay? Possible yun yung kanilang basis ng standard, ng population standard deviation. Okay? So, kinuha din nila ng data in terms of the weight, no? Ang sabi dito, ang claim nila, greater than 700 yung beef chunks doon kapag gidrain na siya. Okay? So, doon ang galing yung data. Okay? Again, yung data sa population pwedeng manggaling sa historical na record. Okay? Example, may historical record tayo sa ano man, sa isang, let's say, sa isang branch, okay, ng, let's say, na isang factory na maliit lang, okay, na-record mo siya, okay, yun yung average na napuputos nila in that day, no? Example, number of glass, no? Yun yung kanilang average na production rate, no? So, may data ka base sa maliit na branch, okay, population yon. Okay. Now, for example, you want to expand. Then, nagpalagay ka ng isang branch, okay, malaki yung capacity. Okay, hindi kaya talaga na kunan ng data lahat. So, kumuha ka lang ng portion. You want to compare kung tama ba talaga yung data mo before doon sa maliit mo na capacity ng branch compare sa malaki. Nag-gets niyo, class? Okay. Bakit? Paano nakuha yung data? Again, yung population data nanggaling yung sa historical record. Okay? Now, you're asked here to use a 0.05 level of significance. Okay? But before we'll start with the solving this, okay, I want you to familiarize or memorize all the symbols. No? Okay, first, okay, mu. Okay, mu, no? Mu means population mean or average. Okay? It has the symbol, Greek alphabet, okay, mu. Ito yung handwriting ko, class. Okay, I suggest since you are required to handwrite later, gamitin nyo na lang ito. Okay, kasi ang ibang interpretation ng students ko, mukha na siyang M. Okay? Again, kindly refer na lang dito sa computer, no? Mu. Next, X bar. Yung may X na may line sa itaas. It means that is sample mean or average. Okay. Another one, okay, memorize, sigma. Population standard deviation. Ito yung sa computer. Okay. Ito na lang gayahin natin. Kasi minsan iba na yung interpretation ng estudyante sa ganito kong handwriting, no? Another one, okay, sample standard deviation. Okay, S, small s. Next is level of significance, okay, alpha. Ito yung sa computer. Ito na lang gayahin natin, class. Kasi pag ginaya nila yung handwriting ko, mukha na siyang L. Okay, better, ito na lang yung ating basihan. Confidence level, okay, is given as 1 minus alpha. Kapag hindi given yung alpha, okay, confidence level yung binibigay ng problem. Please use this formula. And last is the sample size, or N. Okay, so again, please memorize, familiarize the following symbols. Okay, so, okay, next tayo. Okay, balik tayo dito. So the first step is to enumerate all the given. Okay, first, ano 100? Okay, nakalagay, random sample. Okay, memorize man kaya yung ano, yung symbol. N. Okay? So, first natin na given, N is 100. Okay? Now, itong 603 is just name of the cans, no? Pangalan lang yun siya ng lata. Okay, tapos na tayo sa 100. Next, 710.8. I-trace natin kung anong 710.8 nakalagay average. Okay, remember, yung average natin dalawa. Okay, mean. For average, isa lang yun siya. The meaning of mean is average sa statistics, no? Okay? So, it could either population or sample. I-trace natin. Population ba siya sample? Nakalagay, karugtong siya ng sample. So, therefore, this is sample average. Okay, balik tayo sa symbol. Sample average or mean is X bar. Okay? So, X bar is equal to 710.8. So, nakadalawa na tayo, no? Next, assuming the population standard deviation of 8.9, okay, ayan 8.9, binasa ko na, it's standard deviation. Balik tayo symbol, dalawang standard deviation. It could be population or sample. So, I think it's very clear, it's population, no? So, dapat sigma, okay, 3. Okay, nakatatlo na tayong given. Okay, nakalagay population standard deviation. Sigma. Next. Ano ba itong 700? 700. Okay. Ayan, comma, no? Comma. Does this seem to indicate that the mean, okay, mean, average ulit, no? Weight of the beef chunks is greater than 700 grams. So, mean siya, or average. Balik tayo symbol. Okay. May isa pang naiwan, which is the sample mean. No. Population pala. Eh, tama ba sinabi ko kanina? Kamali yung pagsabi ko. Random sample, X bar, no? X bar dapat ito, ha? X bar, kasi sample mean, eh. Okay, so therefore, this 700, mean average pa rin siya, population. Okay. Bakit, sir? Kasi nga, if you trace the statement, population nakalagay. Okay? At saka nagamit na natin yung X bar. So, I think that is the fourth given, which is mu. Okay, mu, yung parang u. Okay, 700. And last given, kapag nakalagay level of significance, ilagay mo as alpha. Okay, alpha na yung directly. So, na-enumerate na natin lahat na given. Okay, next. So, magkaka-idea na kayo kung saan dito na formula. So, focus na sa first na two class, no, kay ITCS man kayo. Muna tayo sa medyo, ano dito, wag na itong komplikado, ha. Ito lang tayo sa first two. Okay, dyan lang kayo tayo mag-focus. Okay, so may idea ka na, uy, given itong lahat dito sa maaring Z siya. Okay, hindi siya pwede sa T kasi nga hindi given yung S. Okay. But may isa pang basis para malaman natin kung saan doon sa dalawa yung gagamitin natin. Actually, paste ko dito kung saan dito sa dalawa. Okay, which is the value of your N. Okay, if the value of your N daw, according to this formula, this author ng book natin, if N is greater or equal to 30, it's Z. Okay, Z-test in short, no? Again, if N is greater or equal to 30, Z-test daw siya. If N is less than 30, T, or T-test. Balikan natin given. Okay? N here is 100. So therefore, nabilong siya dun sa condition na ito, if N is greater or equal to 30, Z. So, may idea na tayo mamaya, it should be Z-test, no? Okay, klaro class, Z-test. Now, ito yung ating procedure, okay? After you enumerate all the given, okay? Enumerate mo natin ang given class, ha? Yan yung given lahat, no? Still remember? N is equal to 100, X bar is 710.8, sigma is 8.9, mu is 700, and alpha is 0.05, okay? Ito na yung algorithm, no? Step 1. You need to state the null hypothesis. We will agree that we will use this variable H sub 0. The other books use H sub A, okay? So sa atin, I strongly encourage to please use H sub 0. Then state mo palagi yung mu. Okay? Huwag na lang tayo sa P, no? Kasi may isa pa. Okay? Sa mu lang tayo. At least, yung kabisado yung isang method ng hypothesis testing, no? Okay? State mo lang mu. Okay? I will explain later, no? Anong kasunod. Then, alternative hypothesis is denoted by H sub 1. Okay, just follow the algorithm. Kasi step 1, a sub 0. Step 2 is a sub 1. Okay, then colon, then mu. Okay. Later ko na-explain yung anong ilalagay nyo dito. Okay. Next, number 3, just write the alpha. State, just write the alpha, 0.05. Number 4, just draw this bell shape, a bell, B-E-L-L, no? Bell shape na graph. Then you label yung center as 0. Okay, just follow the algorithm. Just draw, then you label yung center as 0. Just write a broken line here, a thin line. And number 5, yung computation. Ito na papasok yung formula. Okay, so at least you know already that we should use Z, no? Kasi nga N is 100 and that is greater than 30. And step number 6 is decision. Now, I give emphasis when you're deciding, you always accept or reject step number 1, which is A sub 0. Okay, so start tayo. Okay, under the null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis, okay, partner ito palaging dalawa. Okay? Kapag sinabi sa problem, at least, that means minimum. Nakalagay, greater equal to. Okay? Greater equal to. Opposite niya, less than. Okay? Partner itong dalawa. Next, kapag nakalagay sa problem, maximum at most, okay? Less than equal to. Okay? Opposite niya is greater than. Partner itong dalawa din. Kapag nakalagay sa problem is, okay, equal, partner niya not equal. Kailangan familiarize na lang, lihog na lang klasa. Yung partners, okay? Next. Okay. Given. Step 1. Now, ang step 1 at saka step 2, pwede niyo pagsabayin yung analysis natin, no? Mag-follow lang tayo sa rule, okay, na binigay ko. Kapag H sub 0 o null hypothesis, ito lang po pwede. Okay? Kapag alternative hypothesis or A sub 1, ito lang yung po pwedeng inequality. Okay? Klaro ha? Okay. Now, first at second step. Hindi ko siya na-edit kasi nga in-edit ko yung problem class eh. Okay? Just bear with the internet connection na word ba. Okay? Balik tayo sa problem. Ano ba nakalagay sa problem? Inequality. Okay? Nakalagay greater than, di ba? Greater than. And we all know that 700 is mu. Okay? Greater than. So, mabisualize natin. Ganun, no? Baka mirror ako sa iyo, basta ganun, no? Okay? Saan natin ilalagay? Kung yun lang yung, ito, I'm talking about greater than. Okay? Ito yun. Okay? So, ang greater than, ilalagay natin sa alternative hypothesis or H sub 1. Klaro, no? Kasi yun ang sa problem. Okay, greater than alternative hypothesis or A sub 1. Ang partner niya, which is A sub 0, ito, less than equal to. Okay, that is why, okay, tandaan, ang nakalagay sa problem is greater. Okay? Saan nakalagay ang greater? Alternative hypothesis, H sub 1. That is why, okay, dapat yung pagsabayin is ang step 1 at saka 2. Depende sa given, in short. No? Dito ko nilagay. H sub 1. Kasi yun instruction sa algorithm eh. Kapag nakalagay sa problems greater than, ilagay mo sa alternative hypothesis. Now, the opposing niya na inequality, okay, balik tayo doon. Yan. Opposing niya is, sabi ko kanina partner, di ba? Less than equal to. So, kaya, step 1, less than equal to. Okay? So, ganun lang. Okay, ang instruction dito, tingnan niyo yung problem, anong given, tapos balikan nyo ito. Balikan nyo lang ito. Okay? Para hindi kayo malito. Okay, next. We're done with step number 2. It's 3. Just write the given alpha. Okay? Number 4, you draw this bell shape. You draw lang yung bell shape. You label center, okay, 0, thin line. Now, what's the purpose of this? Okay? Para malaman nyo kung nasaan nyo dapat ilalagay yung positive, negative. We all know that all values na negative should be put on the left side of your zero. Okay, agree, no? Dapat negative natin nasa left side ng zero. Ang positive nasa right side ng zero. Okay. So, what's the purpose of the shaded portion? Yung shaded portion natin, ang basihan natin is step number 2. Okay? Step number 2, palagi ang shaded na portion. Okay, ito yun, no? Kapag greater than, Okay? Imagine nyo lang yung tip ng arrow. Di ba parang tip siya ng arrow? Ito is pointing to the right. Kaya yung shaded portion natin nasa right side. Okay? So balik tayo sa shaded portion. Kaya I shaded this portion. Now, let's agree on this. Yung pag-shade ng ating graph, it should be one half, no, one third of the one half. Okay? Is ano natin, i-cut natin to three portion itong one half. Okay? Di ba, mga one third siya? One third of this one half na bell shape. Okay? That is why hanggang dito lang ako. Huwag naman sobrahan, class, ha? Again, let's agree on this. One third of the one half. Okay? Kaya tanong, kaya nung di naman sakto, no? Importante sakto. Basta mag-shade lang kayo. You put the vertical line, then you shade. Okay? So, tapos na sa shaded portion. Next. After that, okay, you label this. Ano bang label nitong shaded na portion? And that is your step number 3, which is 0.05. No? So, ang sukat ng shaded na portion natin is step number 3. Okay? 0.05. Okay, next. We need to look for the value at this point, this boundary. No? Yan, boundary na yan. Paano? Okay? Since we already know that this one is z-test, okay? How? Again, by looking at your n value. Your n value is 100, and that is greater than 30. According to Ronald Walpole, if n is equal to, if n is greater or equal to 30, it should be z-test. Okay? That is why z dapat siya na formula ang gagamitin natin, and we will be using the z distribution table. Okay? Open natin ang z distribution table. Okay. Ito ang z distribution table class. Okay? Kita no? Paano namin malaman, sir? Okay, nakalagay z. Nakalagay din z dito. Okay? Kasi yung isa is t distribution table. Ito yung isa, no? Nakalagay kasi T dito at saka nakalagay T distribution. So dito kayo mag-follow. Okay, ito yung gamitin pala natin. Now, I just want to explain kung ano yung nasa loob nito, okay? Yung nasa loob ng table na ito is actually your alpha, okay? Alpha ito. So ibig sabihin yung alpha given na natin kanina is 0.05, right? Balikan natin. Okay, 0.05 yung alpha natin kanina. Okay, yan, no? 0.05. So, hanapin lang natin dun sa table ng 0.05. Dito sa loob ng table. Hanapin natin. Okay, 0.05. Okay. Nasa gitna siya ng okay, dalawang values na ito. Okay, 0.0505 at saka 0.0495. Again, ang 0.05 is nasa gitna nito. Bakit dito pwede, sir? Hindi naman sa gitna si 0.05. Hindi din nasa gitna si 0.05. So, dito lang talaga siya po pwede. Okay, ang 0.05 nasa gitna ng 0.0505 at 0.0495. So, nandito sa gitna. Okay. Now, other authors okay, will instruct you kapag ganito yung situation, use interpolation. Okay, but I will not instruct you to use interpolation. Just use averaging. Okay, tingin sa gilid. Okay, nasa gitna man siya. Okay? So, anong values na malapit sa kanya? 0.0505, no? That's the first value na malapit sa 0.05. Tingin sa gilid, negative 1.6, correct? Okay. Sa itaas, 0.04. Okay? So, in short, yung z value niya is 1.6 at saka 0.04. If the value sa gilid is negative, assume sa taas negative din. Okay, klaro, class? If you will add, okay, negative nito sa itaas, again, the instruction, kapag negative ito sa gilid, negative sa itaas, if you will add, parang nag-add lang din kayo ng dalawang positive, no? Kaya lang you put negative, no? So, negative 1.6 plus negative na itong 0.04, will give you negative 1.64. Okay, klaro, ha? Negative 1.64. Then after that, okay, isa pa lang yun, no? Okay, ito pa yung isa na malapit sa 0.05. Yung 0.0495. Tingin sa gilid, negative 1.6. Okay, sa itaas, okay, 0.05. Since that is negative sa gilid, you assume negative sa itaas. So, you add negative 1.65. So, dalawa yung values, no? Negative 1.64 and negative 1.65. Okay, you get the average, okay? Use your calculator, that will give you negative 1.65. Okay? No, tama ba? No. negative 1.645, okay, tama, no? Negative 1.645, no? That's the value. Use your calculator, just get the average of negative 1.64 and negative 1.65. Okay, the answer is negative 1.645, okay, check natin. Okay, there, no? Okay, negative 1.645. Now, I assume immediately it should be positive. Why? Because I told you the purpose of zero is para malaman mo kung saan ang negative, saan yung positive. Ang shaded portion natin is nasa right side. So it should be assumed as positive. Okay, klaro, class? Okay, so just get rid of the positive, no? After you compute, baga, nagkulang lang siguro sa solution dito, it should be negative 1.64 plus negative 1.65, that will give you negative 1.645, okay? Then, remove negative sign, this is positive 1.645, okay? Tinuro ko lang sa yung shortcut class kasi may malong method dito eh, that you need to deduct 1.05 sa 1, no? To get the positive number, but I will not teach you that, no? Dito lang tayo sa madali, okay? Next. After that, step number 4 na tayo, 5 na tayo. Number 5, just use the formula under the z-test, no? Okay? Sa anong formula yun? Balikan natin. Okay, itong formula na to. Okay? X-bar minus mu divided by sigma divided by square root of n. Okay? So, that is the formula. So, just substitute all the given. Using your calculator, the answer is 12.13. Okay? Now, after that, you need to go back. The next algorithm, you need to go back with number 4. Okay? Anong gagawin namin, sir? Okay, nakulang lang 1 dito, class. Pakiano na lang, ha? It should be 12.13. Okay, paano namin malocate dun sa ano, sir, sa figure? Okay? Diba, itong point na ito is 1.645. Okay? Yan kinuha natin dun sa table, no? Now, the answer is, dun sa step number 5 is 12.13. Okay, the question is it before this point or after? Okay? I think you will all agree with me that it should be after. Kasi nga, mas malaki si 12.3 kaysa 1.645. So, in short, nabilong siya sa shaded na portion. Hindi naman stricto kung saan banda, no? Nagkamali lang ako, sobrang siguro ng, na ano dito, ng shade. Dito yan siya, yung point na yan. Okay, nasa line pa rin siya ng x-axis, okay? Yung point na yan. It should be 12.3, okay? So, pwede siya kahit saan actually, okay? So, again, ang importante lang doon, dito, no? Nabilong ba siya sa shaded na portion o hindi? Because shaded portion is rejection area. Again, shaded portion is rejection area. Kapag nabilong yung step number 5 mo sa rejection area, okay? Step number 6 decision, you need to reject. Again, bakit siya reject, sir? It's because yung number 5 mo na belong sa shaded na portion. So, you need to reject. So, therefore, okay, the claim of the manufacturer that the average net weight of the meat is greater than 700 grams is true. Okay, ganun nagkakandak ng hypothesis testing kung tama yung ginawa ng isang researcher o hindi, no? So, true. True daw. Bakit, sir? Important of your step number 1. Again, I told you kanina, okay, step number, ito dito, after this step number 6, we always accept or reject step 1 for a sub-zero. Okay? So, ano ba yung nire-reject natin? So, balik tayo dito step number 1. Okay? Di ba ito yung opposite ng claim? Because the claim is yung product niya naglalaman ng greater than 700 grams of beef chunks. Okay? So, napatunayan niya that it's not true. Using the testing hypothesis, no? So the claim of the manufacturer that the average net weight of the meat is greater than 700 is not true. Wait lang. Oh, tama nga, reject. Okay, it's true pala. Okay, sorry ha, it's true, no? Because you're rejecting it, eh. Okay, nagkamali ako, ha? Okay. You're rejecting this, which is the opposite of the claim. Okay, you're rejecting the opposite of the claim. So in short, you're accepting it, right? Again, you're rejecting the opposite of the claim. So in short, you're accepting it. Okay? So therefore, number 6, the claim of the manufacturer of the that the average net weight of the meat is greater than 700 grams is true. Okay, nasabi ko na not true, ha? Okay, mali yun, ha? Is true. Kasi because you are rejecting the null hypothesis. Okay, time check 3, almost 3:30. Okay, end ko muna yung recording class na.